Hi, welcome to an Arduino tutorial for Robojax. My name is Ahmad Shamshiri. In this tutorial, I'm going to show you how we can control an RGB LED using Arduino to get different color, or using this RGB LED module, or standalone RGB LED like this. See how we can calculate the resistors. Then you want to find out the pins, subtract and divide by 0.018, and you get 155 ohm resistor. You can get the code for this by clicking at the link in the description below, which will take you to robojax.com/learn/Arduino. Let's get started with this. So what is an RGB LED? RGB LED is a light emitting diode, and RGB stands for red, green, and blue. So RGB means a combination of three diodes in one package that have either a common cathode or common anode. So the common anode is that these are anodes. Anodes are common. This pin is called anode, and this is on this side, which we have a line, is called cathode. So anode, common anode, all of them are common, and you just turn on cathode of whichever you want. For example, if you want the red to be turned on, so this is connected to positive, all of them will have. You just need to connect the negative to this cathode of red. If you connect negative to this, the green will be turned on. If you connect it to this, the blue will turn on. Same thing, this time the cathodes are connected together to the negative, and you will connect the positive to anode of each of those to be turned on. A combination of colors will create different color for you if you combine. The combination of color will create the color, this color for you. As you can see here, this is red, green, blue. The maximum value that you get is 255. Now this times mean, this means red is full brightness and green and blue are zero. There is no color of blue and green, so that's why you're getting red. And for green, you get 255, so now it's full green. And then if you want blue, just turn that one off, and then 255 will give you blue. So pay attention here. If you want color black, red, green, and blue must be zero. So when there's no color exists, that's why we call it black. If you want this one to be white, so all of them should have maximum. So with combining red, green, and blue, you can get white color. This is also true in real life. I will provide the link for this so you can play with the color. The combination of both of these will give you another color. For example, if you have blue and then red, you will get pink. Or if you want green and red, you get yellow. Or if you get these two colors, you get aqua. And then the variation of all those numbers. As I move this, this is in the blue. If I want to go in this area within different shades of green, or if I go and here, different shades of red, from darkest to any color you want. The hex value or hexadecimal value that are used in many applications. 181, 62, and 83. So these are the value B and 5 and 3E and 53. If I put here 0, you see that becomes 0, green 0. The second two digits will become 0. Now 83 in terms of decimal is 53 in terms of hex. If I put this 0, that one also becomes 0. If I go to 55, you will see this will become FF. FF. So the first two digits are for red, two are for green, and two are for blue. And we have two types of LEDs. Either this regular LED with different sizes, from 1 or 2 millimeters, it goes 10 to 15 millimeter huge sizes. And this is SMD or surface mount device, that we have three LEDs connected together in a surface mount. This is the surface mount device. It has three pin and one common. For that reason, they've connected it as green, ground, red, green, and blue. Even you can see the actual, under this lens, you can see those pieces that I've shown you. And here, this is the diode that I just spoke about. So this has one common and then T. This is common cathode and this is also common cathode. If you see VCC on any of this module, then that module is common anode. And if you see ground and ground, this is common cathode. Here is a data sheet. For example, this is one of the surface mount LED. And that shows here, for example, for the pen, current that they need is 18.5 milliampere, typical for this one. And here is the operating voltage for red, green, blue, 1.8 to 2.2. And then for the green is 3 to 3.2 and blue is 3.2 to 3.4. Keep that in mind, and that the average LED currents for each piece, for red, for green and blue, about 20 milliampere, and average voltage is around 2 volts. As you saw, it was from 1.8 to 2 point something or even 3, but average is around 2.2 volts and average current is about 20 milliampere. So based on that average, you can do your calculation or refer to the data sheet of each specific LED that you purchase. Now let's see how we can calculate the resistors. This is common anode. You will put your resistor at cathodes, and each LED will have separate independent resistor, and they're almost equal, so you can calculate the same value and put for all, unless it's very critical. And if you have common cathode, again, the side that is common, you leave it, and on the other side, you just put, now this side, the resistors are in anode. So let's say on the data sheet you read that the voltage of LED is 2.2 volts and rated current I is 18 milliampere, and the VCC that you want to connect is 5 volts, and that 18 milliampere will be 0.018 ampere. So let's say you want to find the resistor. So this is the formula: VCC minus VLED divided by I. So V over I is equal R, 5 volts. This is VCC is 5 volts and LED voltage is 2.2, subtract and divide by 0.018, and you get 155 ohm resistor. If you go with the lower voltage, 3.3 volts, that only this has changed, and you get 61 ohm. And if you're connecting an LED to 12 volts, the same thing, 12 minus 12, 2.2, and this is the current, 544 ohm resistor is needed. If any of these values are not available directly, for example, you will not find 155, you might get 150 ohm resistor, and then 68 ohm resistor, or 560 ohm, which are one of the standard resistors that are closer, you can get it. And this module has that three resistors, 1, 2, and 3, and if I put magnifier, if you look at it, it says 102, if you can read it. That 102 means 1, and then 02 means 2 zeros. They put 1 kilo ohm, making sure that this module can work, let's say, up to 18 volts or higher voltages. And on this one, also, we have these resistors, the three. You can see the resistors are rated, written 102, that's 1 kilo ohm. Now let me explain the wiring. I've connected pin 11, 12, and 13 from Arduino. As you can see, this is on this side accordingly. And then the last pin, green, is ground. So ground is connected here. And then I have 11, and then 12 and 13 are connected here. And if you have this type of LED in your hand and you want to find out the pins, as you can see, one of the pins is the longest one, and that is the common. Connected these two wires here to 3.3 volts and ground. So this is ground, 3.3 volts in the common, and then move this, connected to this. Now it's turned on, connected to that. The second one turned on, blue. So that's R, that is G, that is B, blue. And if you reverse it, you see that the light will not turn on. so you know that the positive is common, and that when positive is common, we call it common anode. Let me now explain the code. At the top of the line, first I've defined for the red, green and blue, pin 11, 12 and 13. These are for pulse width modulation control of the different value. And then we have this as a color time that between each color this sketch will show. So I set it for 2 seconds or whatever you want. And these are the colors that are a little famous. So I just put a few colors with the name. And these are the value, white, red, green, blue, and all these values, including pink, aqua, yellow, brown. And I put in another array these names, so it will print it for us on the serial monitor. And then we set up serial monitor with 9600 baud. Make sure that this 9600 baud is selected accordingly, so you can see it. After that, we set the red. The red is defined here as, for example, 13, and all those values, this is just a number, and we set it as an output, and then we set it as low, so the LED is off. And then we set the green, and also and the position. We set the green pin as an input, as an output, blue pin as an output, and also set them as low. After that, inside the loop, I've written this for loop, which goes from 0 to 7, in 8 steps, so it goes for 8 different colors that I've defined here to print all those colors for us, or turn the LED with those colors. And here it's, we say color J, this J becomes 0, 1, 2, 3, and 4, and then color J0 means the first color, color J1 means the second, color J2 means the third one. So this is the R, this is the G, this is the B, RGB 0, 1, 2. And it has been defined here, R, G, and B. All of those will have 3 values. So it passes this value into RGB LED and prints this text for us and wait for the time that we set above. And this time that we set here for 2 seconds. Now let's have a look at this function, RGB LED. RGB LED receives the value, and we call them here r, small g, small b. And then once we receive them, we send to this pin the value, to the green pin this value, to the blue pin this b value, will turn the LED for us. So this makes our code very neat. And the loop continues like that. After this, it will just go and repeat it. Let me now demonstrate the color. The system is starting. As you can see, it shows white, red, green now, blue, yellow, aqua, pink, brown. The camera doesn't show properly the color, but if you go further away, because the camera is very close, you will see actual real color, because they will be mixing up. And we are here, the camera is very close up, so you can distinguish and see each LED. All those billboards that you see, majority of those are based on this RGB, and that's why you don't see any difference, and it looks like actual color photo. Thank you for watching. This was how to use these two types of RGB LED and control them with Arduino. If you learned something and found this useful, please thumb up, as this will help my video in the search algorithm of YouTube. If you have comment or question, please post it at the comment section below. I try to answer and reply. And to get updates of my upcoming videos, make sure to subscribe.